Good morning, children. Praise the Lord. We meet again today. Stay happy and healthy in this new day. Before we start our today's activities, let's listen to God's word this morning. Taken from the book Straight Ahead, written by Adlai Aiste, PhD. And this morning, we will learn from the title, Kind Deeds in Secret. Before we proceed, shall we start with a prayer? Thank you, Lord, for the new day. Now we are ready to listen to your words. May your Holy Spirit be within us to lead us and bless us. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Our memory verse for today is from Matthew chapter 6, verses 3-4. It says, "But when you give to the needy, do not let your left hand know what your right hand is doing, so that your giving may be in secret." Children, in one of our state capitol buildings, the newsstand concessions were given to Pete, a blind man who operated the business successfully. With training and experience, he had developed very sensitive fingers. He could make the right change quickly and efficiently. His customers learned to love him and to trust him. He never complained, even though his wife was sick and all the hospital expenses put them in debt. However, one day, his customers could not help but detect a worried look from him. They soon learned the full story from others. For Pete never uttered a word of complaint or discouragement, and things began to happen at the newsstand. Pete was aware of the need for a great deal of change. He could hardly keep sufficient coins on hand to meet the demand. It seemed that nearly every customer, as they bought the daily paper, would say, "Sorry, Pete, but could you please give me change for a dollar?" as they handed him a bill in payment. This kept up all week, and Pete did not know what was happening. And he never learned until he went to the bank at the end of the week. There, the mystery was solved. It turns out that every bill in his cash box was either a $5, $10, or $20 bill. There was enough money to pay off his debts. However, Pete did not know who his benefactors were, and he did not know how to thank the individual donors. Only God knew who they were and how much they had given. So Pete had a large sign prepared, and when he returned to his newsstand for the first day of the week, his loyal customers saw something besides his big genial smile. It reads, "Thanks, you wonderful people." Children, the master once taught that it is more blessed to give than to receive. Pete's customers felt a warm glow around their hearts as they saw the happy smile on his face. They knew that they had helped one of God's worthy children, and there must have been many who have remembered some words of Jesus, "Then your Father who sees what is done in secret will reward you. Matthew chapter 6, verse 4. This is the end of our morning worship. Children, are you ready to do good deeds today? Ask Jesus to help you open your eyes to see people around you who need your help. And remember that your good deeds are done in secret, for your Father in heaven, who sees hidden things, will repay you. Children, let's do good things today. Let's be a blessing to others, for it is more blessed to give than to receive. May the Lord Jesus bless and protect all of the children on this wonderful day. Amen.